it was a surprise, but we perhaps were anticipating a real strengthening of TSMC's business because of AI.
Yeah, I mean, all roads lead to Taiwan right now. If you're going to build anything, whether it's Nvidia and their data center accelerators, whether it's AMD, who are doing better in servers than Intel, who are also getting into data center accelerators, whether it's Broadcom and the networking, you are going to TSMC and you are paying for their most expensive stuff.
That is pretty much a shape of the industry kind of story. There are some specific names that are interesting. Meta is interesting, a story you've been writing about with Asia Counts. We've just broken the story that they're bringing a next-gen MTIA chip, but this is the in-house silicon they want to deploy for their own training and inference purposes. What do you make of it?
I mean, this is them basically joining that long list and lengthening list of these companies that think, hey, I can do this better in terms of what I can...
Better than who?
Well, that's the problem, isn't it, right? They don't want to be paying the massive premiums that they're paying to NVIDIA, but they still are. But when it comes to a general purpose processor like this one, perhaps we can do it better than Intel.
Isn't it fascinating that we see this after the day, after the cloud event coming from Alphabet, where there is just this ongoing tension of these big providers of cloud, but also runners of AI and builders of large language models, wanting to depend on NVIDIA, but not too much, and ultimately having to be frenemies, Ian. Is this a relationship that can continue?
I mean, it's been going on for years now. If you look at AWS is the progenitor of this trend, and they have really shown that, look, we can, you know, we've got the size to make the economics work, so we will do this as much as we can. But at the same time, the real silicon companies that have been around for years are still just about in the lead. They're still able to push the performance to the limit. So that's the balance that's been struck.
Let's end on Intel. Intel has introduced its latest AI accelerator, Gaudi 3. It will be available in the third quarter of this year, but likely not at scale. And its performance is where Pat Gelsinger has focused. What else do we need to know about Gaudi 3?
Well, it's not so much about Gaudi 3, really. It's the elephant in the room, which is what NVIDIA announced earlier this year, which is they'll have their new Blackwell architecture in the market probably around that time. And as Gelsinger was forced to basically admit yesterday, we don't know how we'll compare to that. And the inference that people have taken from that is you won't be able to compare to that.